Hey everybody, Aaron Rift here from NoDQ.com to take a look at Hulk Hogan's WrestleMania matches, and I will be ranking them today from worst to best. Hulk Hogan was a major name in WrestleMania history. No question that he was a major superstar that helped make WrestleMania what it was. And without Hulk Hogan, who knows if WrestleMania would have even taken off. No question you had Vince McMahon and Ronnie Piper, Mr. T, and other people that helped make WrestleMania, but Hulk Hogan was a phenomenon in the mid-1980s that was sweeping the world, and Hulk Hogan and WrestleMania just go together. So let's take a look at these matches here. Starting off with the worst Hulk Hogan matches, I think most people would agree on this one. Hulk Hogan versus Yokozuna, the worst Hogan WrestleMania match. Hard to even call it a match because basically what happened was Yokozuna beat Bret Hart for the WWF title, and then Hulk Hogan came out, Mr. Fuji issued an open challenge, Hulk Hogan got in the ring, and in less than a minute beat Yokozuna and won the title. And Bret Hart, who had been pushed as the face of WWE, was now in the shadow of Hulk Hogan again. And didn't even make much sense because a couple months later, Hulk Hogan was gone from the company and they had to go back to Bret Hart as the top guy. So, you know, it was counterproductive in the long run and, wasn't really anything of a match. Next up here, speaking of WrestleMania 9, Hulk Hogan and Brutus Beefcake against Money Inc. I actually really enjoyed the build-up to this match. They did this angle where Money Inc. used the briefcase, IRS's briefcase, on Brutus Beefcake, and he became Brutus Briefcase. And Jimmy Hart, who was the manager of Money Inc., turned babyface and joined up with Hogan and Beefcake, which was cool. But the match itself, I mean, wasn't much to it. I was actually very disappointed with it, and Hogan and Beefcake, I thought that they were going to win the tag team titles in this match, and it didn't happen. And, it was weak. Could have been a lot better. And speaking of could have been a lot better, Hulk Hogan versus Sid Justice at WrestleMania 8. This was an interesting match. Not the original main event match that was planned for WrestleMania. Originally, it was supposed to be Hulk Hogan versus Ric Flair, but plans got changed. And instead, we got Hulk Hogan versus Sid Justice. And they were coming off the Royal Rumble angle where Hogan was eliminated by Sid. He got pissed off and he grabbed Sid's arm, and that allowed Ric Flair to throw out Sid, and Ric Flair ended up winning the title. This match was not so good. The most memorable thing about it was, first of all, Sid kicking out of Hogan's leg drop, and then there was this big confusion because Papa Shango was supposed to do a run-in and he missed his cue. So, Hogan and Sid are just standing there in the ring and, they're stalling for time. Papa Shango finally comes down, and then the Ultimate Warrior's music hits, and the Warrior makes his surprise return, helps Hogan clean house, and him and Hogan celebrate to end WrestleMania. So, I mean, the ending was way better than the match itself. Next up, Hulk Hogan versus Sergeant Slaughter at WrestleMania 7. This angle could have been a huge success for WWE. Sergeant Slaughter was getting a lot of heel heat, being the Iraqi sympathizer, and even getting death threats. But, it didn't really connect with people, and it didn't do as well at the box office as WWE was hoping. Originally they wanted to hold WrestleMania at the LA Coliseum, and they ended up having to move it to the sports arena, and they claimed it was because of a bomb threat, but the word is that the ticket sales were very disappointing, and that's why they made the switch. And the match itself was very predictable. Hulk Hogan, the red, white, and blue good guy, overcoming the heel Sergeant Slaughter, Iraqi sympathizer, and Hulk Hogan wins. He's covered in blood, he's got the American flag, he wipes the blood off with the flag, it's just another Hulk Hogan victory at WrestleMania. Moving on here, Hulk Hogan versus Andre the Giant, the second WrestleMania match at WrestleMania 4. This was part of the WWF title tournament, and not much of a match at all, and you know, it didn't have the mystique that the first match had, so you know, that hurt it. And you know, Andre was a year older and a year more broken down, and you know, very slow paced, and you had DiBiase out there, and you know, that made the match a little bit more interesting, and ended up with a double disqualification, so both guys were eliminated from the match, and you know, just wasn't as special as the other Hogan Andre matches. Hulk Hogan versus King Kong Bundy at WrestleMania 2. You know, at the time, this was a pretty good cage match, in my opinion. Wasn't great or anything, but, you know, Bundy was a very credible opponent for Hogan. And I liked the storyline that they did leading up to it with Bundy hurting the ribs of Hogan. And, you know, he was all taped up, and, you know, they were really putting over Bundy as this unstoppable monster. But, you know, Hulk Hogan's Hulk Hogan. He overcame the big man, and he won the cage match. And, you know, it was just your typical Hulk Hogan beating the big man title defense. Nothing all that special about it, but, you know, definitely wasn't a bad match. Hulk Hogan and Mr. T versus Paul Orndorff and Roddy Piper at the first WrestleMania. Not a great match, and you know, you had Mr. T in there, and it was all about the glitz and glamour and, you know, the personalities. It wasn't about the in-ring action. You know, very historic match because it was the main event of the first WrestleMania, and, you know, it was a match that helped WWE gain mainstream popularity and made them a worldwide phenomenon. So, you know, it was a very historically significant match. You know, not that good, but like I said, was about the personalities, wasn't about the quality in the ring. Hulk Hogan versus Vince McMahon at WrestleMania 19. I think that this match was way better than anybody thought going in. I don't think these two could have had a better match on any other night. You know, it worked about as well as one could hope for. And once again, it wasn't about the quality of the in-ring work. It was about the personalities. You know, Hulk Hogan and Vince going back to the 80s with the formation of WrestleMania, and you know, into the 90s when Hogan left Vince and went to WCW and tried to put WWE out of business with Ted Turner. So, you know, it was a very interesting feud, and they were able to take real life and mix it into storyline, and you know, it was a very interesting match, and you even had a surprise return from Roddy Piper coming out and helping Vince and attacking Hogan. So, you know, you had a lot of things going on in this match, and, you know, it was all about, you know, the two characters going at it, and, you know, I was very entertained by it. Next up, Hulk Hogan versus Randy Savage from WrestleMania 5. In my opinion, this was the best Hulk Hogan match from a technical in-ring work standpoint. You know, Savage really carried this, and, you know, I think it was Hogan at his best athletically when he was in there with Randy Savage. And, you know, he had a tremendous storyline leading up to this match. You know, Hogan and Savage were the mega powers, and, you know, they were best friends. Hogan helped Savage win the title at WrestleMania 4. And the thing I loved about this feud is that it was very slow build. You know, at SummerSlam, they had a little tease. And then at Survivor Series, they had a bigger tease. And at the Royal Rumble, there were more issues between the two of them, you know, over Elizabeth. And then finally at the main event show on NBC, you had, you know, Elizabeth getting knocked down and Hogan taking her to the back, leaving Randy Savage in the ring with the Twin Towers. And then Savage goes to the back, gets in Hogan's face, and then attacks him. I thought this was all tremendous. And the match itself, I mean, the two of them really had their working shoes on. And, you know, Hogan was really giving it his best effort in the ring. And I thought it was technically a very good match. One of Hogan's best, in my opinion, in terms of in-ring work. So, you know, Hogan and Savage, in my opinion, was great. Hulk Hogan versus Andre the Giant at WrestleMania 3. One of the most historic WWE matches of all time. One of the most iconic matches. You know, everybody knows the body slam. Hulk Hogan body slamming Andre the Giant. and you know, the mystique of this match, 93,000 Pontiac Silverdome. Everybody knows the story, and you know, it's one of Hulk Hogan's most memorable moments of his career. The reason why it's not number two or number one for me is because I don't think the match was any good. Technically, it was awful. I mean, there it was just, you know, Andre could not do all that much. And, you know, I remember them being on the outside of the ring, and, you know, Hogan was trying to pile drive Andre on the floor, and Andre back body dropped him, and it looked so bad. And, you know, the stuff that was crucial, you know, the body slam, you know, that worked to perfection. That was fine. And, you know, the end of the match, you know, no issues, but everything else before it, not so good. But, you know, it is what it is, a legendary match, and, you know, one of Hogan's top matches. Hulk Hogan versus the Ultimate Warrior at WrestleMania 6. This was another iconic match. The two top baby faces in WWE going at it. WWE champion versus the Intercontinental champion. And, you know, you had the crowd split down the middle, some cheering for Hogan, some cheering for Warrior, these two larger-than-life figures. And the match itself, once again, was about as good as you could expect from these two, and maybe even better than you would expect. You know, Hogan and Warrior went out there, and, you know, they told a story in the ring. And, you know, it wasn't the flashiest match of all time, but, you know, in terms of, you know, just the flow of the match and the storytelling between the two characters, you know, having the test of strengths and going back and forth. You know, I really enjoyed the match, and, you know, it's an all-time WWE classic. And finally, the number one Hulk Hogan match at WrestleMania, Hulk Hogan versus The Rock at WrestleMania 18. When you think of dream matches and the greatest dream match in the history of wrestling that actually, you know, happened, and we actually got to see it, you know, Hulk Hogan versus The Rock would be number one. A match you thought you would never see, two of the biggest stars from different eras going at it. And one thing you also weren't expecting was the reaction that Hulk Hogan got when he came out there. I mean, I figured going in Hogan would get a big reaction, and you know, maybe it would be a split crowd, but when Hogan came out there, almost every single person in that building was cheering for Hulk Hogan and booing The Rock. And it was just something else to see. I mean, there was, I don't even know if there's ever been a crowd atmosphere like that one. And, you know, it was so unique and just a magical moment if you were a Hulk Hogan fan to see him come back at WrestleMania and be in a headline match against The Rock. And it was amazing. I mean, Hogan, technically the match, you know, wasn't that good. I mean, it was better than Hogan and Andre, but wasn't a whole lot better. You know, Hogan couldn't do much. He was doing back rakes to The Rock, and the crowd was popping like it was the greatest spot they've ever seen in their lives. So, you know, that just goes to show you how much the crowd added to this match. If you took out the crowd, it wouldn't have been a very good match. But, you know, the crowd made this, and to me, this is the number one match for Hulk Hogan at WrestleMania. Really made it clear that he was immortal and he could come back, and Hulk Hogan will always be a major superstar in wrestling history. So, you know, that's my number one. Let me know what you guys think. Leave a comment, youtube.com/NoDQCAW. And stay tuned to NoDQ.com for the very latest news in WWE and TNA. Thank you for watching.